Well, let's fix me first, and then start the stream. Let's see, I'm trying to get slightly away from you. Okay. It's not great, you can kind of see the green behind me, but I'll deal with it today. I don't know what's causing that. So let's see, why isn't the game coming up? Well, this is odd. It says it's getting the correct, let's try this one. There we go. Okay. And, oh, well, then I knock over my camera. That's how today's gonna go. So let me put it back for a sec. Hope it's not actually my camera that's weird. Cause now that happened, I look like I have holes in me. Here, let's mess with the lighting again a little bit more. Made it worse. Ooh, maybe that's it. I don't know what's up. This is bizarre. Seems as long as I'm still to get rid of it. What happens when I put too much light? It honestly actually looks a little better. Just a little. I might deal with it today because I'm in a rush. But, well, not like a rush, but. You know what? I'm going to deal with being a little green. All right.
The third member of the Fiendish Five was the infamous voodoo priestess, Ms. Ruby. Born into a family of mystics, other children found her scary. Teaching herself to summon the undead provided what few friends she had. A career in crime allowed an adult Ms. Ruby to punish the world for fearing her as a child. Chief mystic for the Fiendish Five, her powers allowed them to break both the laws of man and nature at the same time. Yet despite the whirlwind success of her youth, she managed to slip into obscurity. Last known sightings claim she headed out of civilization and deep into the Haitian jungle.
Sly Cooper and Vicious Voodoo. This is the generic scary level that each game, which of the first three games, has.
Sorry, Sly, but this is one mission you will have to accomplish without me.
You don't believe in ghosts, do you?
Sure I do. My scanners have picked up verifiable paranormal activity. But that's not the problem. This swamp is oozing with disgusting mold and bacteria.
Suck it up, Bentley. We got work to do.
All right, then. Don't forget to use the new move you learned from Mugshot section of the Thievius Raccoonus.
You mean the raccoon rail walk?
The roots and vines around here are perfect for that. All you gotta do is
jump and hit the circle button.
Especially where you see the bark has been worn away, and where it's super slick from Mickey slime and moss, you'll rail slide like a skater grinding pipe.
I'm liking it.
Oh my god. I don't think I've ever accidentally jumped into that flame before.
robots, and I'm warning you, they're mean and they work like a team.
So do we, buddy.
That's a rough start to that. Ooh, but he's facing the wrong way and none of the other ones showed up. They're coming. I'm getting the sense that I missed a couple clues.
You've done it! The Lojo force field is down, and you can steal the key!
Because I know there's one up here, but I doubt there's two more that direction that I missed. Oh, dang, there's not one up here. See, I missed three somewhere. Because they're not interlaced here. Well, I'd gone a long time without missing any. So I guess it was bound to happen. And I don't think you can actually return from this. And I've already hit these checkpoints, so... ugh. We're just gonna have to do this mission a few times. I'm gonna do another quick check. Yeah, nope. Oh wait, this sends me back to the gate. So yeah, that's the same problem. I have to do it this way. Good news, according to the thing that flashed, we're half done with the game. I know I got the one behind the Tiki. I feel like the ones that I missed are gonna make me pretty upset when I find out. Like they're probably somewhere right in front of me. Was it at the top where those two swamp monsters are? I think it was there. Yep, can't believe I missed this. Yeah. There we go.
Press the circle to enter the vault code. If I did my math right, and I always do my math right, then the combination has got to be 588. Of himself to confuse guards into attacking the wrong thing. Use the triangle button to put together a fake Sly Cooper.
Oh, don't have roll on. Alright. Bit of a hiccup.
My paranormal scanner is maxing out on that structure.
A reading like that can only be coming off Ms. Ruby herself.
I think you're right, Sly. If you want to crack at Ms. Ruby, you're going to have to find a way inside that skull temple.
That section alone makes me think that Ms. Ruby's probably the most terrifying of the Fiendish Five. I mean, like, in terms of power.
What's this industrial strike voodoo gate? Ms. Ruby must really be trying to keep something out.
Or maybe she's trying to keep something in.
Because, I mean, Clockwork is, you know, a pretty powerful adversary. But he didn't have a zombie horde that could take over a country. So I was trying to remember a speedrun strat that I've actually forgotten. That if I can remember, will make this will make this Master Thief sprint for this level a breeze. But I do not remember that. Here's where the fun begins. Get it. Ah! Okay, well now I need to die on purpose. Oh, I can't die to water. So I just have to get... Wait, what? I probably could have actually booked it for the clue. Let's go ahead and get this clue so I don't have to worry about it. But come on. There we go. This level is not going near as smooth as the first two, unfortunately. Thank you. There we go. Wow. I can't believe I just did that. Ugh, man, I am sorry, guys. This one is... You know what? This might be a blessing in disguise. Now I can see if I can remember this this speedrun strat. Because I know there's a way to get up there. And it's like that. Then we jump up here. We jump down here. Then we have to jump. It's steep, but doable. Good. Well, yeah, because you can't jump from there. This is good practice for when we do the Master Thief Sprint. Okay, so yeah, you can't jump around that, so I gotta figure out how to... I gotta find the angle. There it is. Then, there we go. See, that wasn't so bad. I still wonder if there's like some sort of nerd joke that I'm not getting there.
Electrified. Kelly McCooper's notes on how to harness the electromagnetic field created by a rolling raccoon. Now your raccoon roll move will really pack a punch. Plus, it should give you a nice tingling sensation.
Alright, from this moment onwards, I'll try to make the run a bit smoother. There's a...
Well. Better be on your guard
Now there was not like recently. But in the past couple of years, there's been a huge skip discovered here that I do not know, so I'll not be doing. Thank you. This is one of the few times where a free life is just in the level. That's not very common. They're usually in the hub worlds. I believe I missed this one last year, so let's not do that. I freaked out for a second until I remembered it's the PS2 version when that rope doesn't work. Hated this part as a kid so much. Just if you fall, you go back earlier in the level. It's kind of hard to time jumping and hitting the ghost for a kid. I hated it. You know, this is the beginning of the level, so maybe I don't like it as an adult either. So maybe I should jump over the ghost because it's not going to register. Oh no, now it's going to register though. What? Nope. Not dying to a mosquito. Okay, do not break the key early. Now it's time for the infamous piranhas.
Fly, the only way to open up that voodoo gate is by lighting all 25 tiki torches with the flamethrower on your swamp skiff. Use the left analog stick to steer and press the X button to fire the flamethrower. Oh, and one more thing. You need fuel from the flamethrower, and the only source of oil are those piranha you see swimming around. Run them down with a boat. One fish fuels one shot. Hurry, you only have 2 minutes to get all the torches lit.
I was wondering why Why does he only have 2 minutes to get these torches lit? And another thing, Bentley said you're Swamp Skiff, meaning like Sly owns it. So when did that happen? The music is really messed up. All right, pretty good time. I don't know what was up with the music in that section.
Their production and build up enough steam pressure to get launched up to Ruby's Skull Temple.
Okay, sounds like we've got a plan. To get around that thing, try moving in the shadows made by the masks so that the guards won't see you.
I always hated that Sly is slightly faster than the was faster than the mask.
Holy God, a green waterfall overflowing of bones and body parts. I'm telling you, the health department's going to come down big time on this dump.
My least favorite speedrunning skip is in the beginning of that level. I'm so inconsistent with it, and I will not be trying it. I know I could probably make that jump if I use the hill to boost it, but I'm not gonna do that either. So many of these. I think something has gone wrong in every level I've done today, so I'm gonna play this one safe, which does involve a little bit of backtracking anyway. Wait, can I make that? Yes, okay. I don't think I've ever even thought of trying to get on that. That's a cool little trick where you can actually see the names of all the guards. It's fun. And there we go. Nothing went wrong. Frame drops.
According to my paranormal scan, it's just
actually hope nothing crashes. Oh, dang it. I gotta walk all the way around. Because I wasn't paying attention. I'm gonna go ahead and unlock the door. Before I do this mission, everyone's favorite.
With all the hay and feathers in here, just looking at this place has got me breaking out in hives. But we've got no choice. That ghost over there contacted me on Spectre Wave Radio, and we've cut a deal. He's promised us a key if you can whack 50 chickens. I guess he needs them to make a big pot of gumbo, but he's scared of the bobtoad roosters. Be careful, or they'll blow you to bits. Think you can do it?
Alright, first try. Dang it. Making way better time here. Maybe not way better, but better. That was real close. There we go. And Miss Ruby does have the least amount of Master Thief sprints, so this shouldn't take that long. Let's go. I think there is a specific spot where you can jump down there safely, but we're not gonna need it. Ah. Come on. Don't turn left. See? That one's easy. The angle. Come on. Ooh, save that one. I think the new skip involves this hook right here, but I'm not risking it. That was a bad jump, but I still made it. Ooh, also a bad jump apparently. Come on. I get so conflicted about this world because I love the aesthetic. But there's so many little things about this level that annoy me. And I am referring to Miss Ruby's level as a whole. Okay. What the heck? Okay. I think the hitbox for that, for the Mosquito's Proboscis is way bigger than I remember it being. That was a better jump. Kill the ghost. Jump up. Over here. Ooh, I should have killed the mosquito first. Alright. Do not get killed by a ghost. No! Oh my gosh. Alright. The last two went so well. I'm so disappointed. Oof. Okay. This is rough. Thank you. The fact that I'm having such an off day right here is making me kind of nervous for this boss fight. Again, PS2 version, so the music's actually going to be synchronized right. But boss fight's still kind of annoying. I swear. I wanted to save that for these. No! Oh my god. And there's no iframe, so I'm gonna go up there and get hit by a mosquito, aren't I? Nope. Okay. We have a full minute. So just... ugh. Alright. That nightmare's over. One more. I'm not going to be doing any of the skips, so I just have to do this one on my own merit. Which is apparently not as high as I would hope. Yeah, I could have made that. Maybe this one's actually going to be kind of close. Nah, I got it. All right. Now for the boss.
Cooking up an army of ghosts isn't a very neighborly pastime.
Oh, sly. I see your mouth moving, but all I hear is blah, blah, blah. Well,
secure. You can't run away forever.
Quite true. Quite true. Why don't I have my servant Chumley escort you over here?
All right. What's the catch?
Oh, not much. Just a little game I like to play with all my annoying guests. I want to see how well you pay attention.
What do you mean?
Well, I'll unleash my mighty mojo magic upon you. If you repeat what I do, you'll dodge it just fine. If not, you'll get zapped.
A little voodoo Simon Says, huh? Sounds easy enough.
Oh no. Okay. Oh no, I got hard mode. The frames go way down. Oh no. It should not be like that for the other two, because there's not as much going on. But oh my god. Oh, nope, it is. Okay. I got this. Okay, there's no chickens, no anything else, so please let this one run right. Oh, it seems to.
Like the rest of you. I think I'll manage.
Ms. Ruby's section of the Thievius Raccoonus held notes for my pioneering ancestor, Slight in Common. His invisibility technique allowed him to steal from corrupt pharaohs and greedy noblemen. Right on schedule, Inspector Fox's arrival cued my exit. The production of zombies, made illegal in the World Peace Accord of 71, earned Ms. Ruby a life sentence behind bars. While the gang and I enjoyed a few weeks in the tropical sunshine, working on our tans in preparation for our next caper.
Alright.
Travel plans to China have all been worked out.
And let's see what Murray has to say about this.
Okay, I'll stop. Soon.
he'll stop soon, but I'm going to stop now. Thank you guys for joining me. I am going to do a double today, so I'm going to be on later today to do the Panda Kings level. And hopefully I can get the this fixed so I don't have holes in me. But I will see you guys then. Stay on.